Hello everyone and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program RP-1. In this video, brave team of astronauts will finally make the first footsteps on the surface of Mars. They have just undocked from the Romulus Mars crewed vehicle and are aiming for the landing site at Hellas Basin. This spot has been chosen as this impact basin is quite deep, so the atmospheric pressure at its surface is considerably higher than on most of the other areas of Mars. It will help a lot in aerobraking, thus saving fuel and making landing easier. The lander design is based on Starship, so it also performs a belly flop maneuver. It proves to be quite an efficient way of landing on Mars. Designing this craft took dozens of landing attempts and making tiny changes to aerodynamics, but finally, it ended up being quite reliable at doing it. Flaps are made out of procedural wings, and engines used are 5 RL10 in Lunex configuration. Unlike Starship, parachute is used during the last part of the landing for final deceleration and to save on fuel. Parachute is cut at 500 meters and just the engines ensure soft touchdown. Surprisingly, everything went perfectly fine on the first try. Now, extremely long ladder unfolds and Kerbals are finally able to step out and touch the ground. Hartmut Weber, Catherine Jenkins and Vasily Limonov become first astronauts on the Red Planet. Of course, they plant a flag and they gather some surface samples while waiting for the rover to arrive. The rover is in fact a fully equipped mobile habitat that will host the crew for next month. They will drive around neighboring biomes and collect more samples. Operations for the planet begin. Making a few stops, the crew returns to the lander, and they await for a launch window to come back to Romulus. Ascent went according to the plan, and soon the crew was back at the mothership. yet, it is not the end of the activities. Soon, the lander was refueled with leftover hydrologs, and it headed to visit Phobos and then Deimos. As you can see, these two engines were used to perform injection burn in order to save ignitions. You can also see that I wasn't joking when I've said about hydrologs leftovers. I had just enough to fill the one-third of the capacity of the lander. Before departing to the moons, I've made some calculations and I basically had zero reserve, so I had to be quite efficient with my piloting. Arrival to Phobos went quite smooth, and some moments later I was at the final approach to landing. After anchoring the craft to the ground, crew left the pod to enjoy some time on this extremely low gravity environment. In the meantime, they've collected samples and then they've headed back to the vessel. Next stop, Deimos. Time, landing was performed directly without getting to orbit first. Fuel levels are extremely low already. After landing, there was another session of having fun in low gravity and, of course, collecting samples. Additionally, crew haven't forgotten about placing the flag, like on Phobos some hours earlier. Time to come back to Mothership. The plan for coming back from the beginning was to airbrake into lower orbit. The problem is, there's not enough fuel even to get periapsis into the atmosphere. Fortunately, there is a way to get more delta V, shed some mass. Vasily, mission engineer, went to EVA and unscrewed all the unneeded parts, ladders, landing legs, and two engines with least ignitions. Thanks to that, Delta V got from 630 to 880 meters per second, which will allow for needed burn. But now, to add insult to injury, one of the RL-10 engines failed to ignite, so I've had to shut down the other one and switch to the last center engine. Aerobraking wasn't as smooth as before, as the lander was designed to be stable with its tank full, so the crew had to deal with a bit of spinning. After reaching upper apses, engine lit up to ensure stable orbit. Now, the capsule renamed to Rescue Pod, undocked from the Romulus MCV, and plotted maneuver to rendezvous with stranded crew. At this moment, I was really happy that I've decided not to get rid of capsule service module far back in LEO, as that was the original plan. Has moved to the rescue pod, taking all the samples taken on surface. Then they have separated, and the lander was left in orbit as space junk. Welcomed the safety of the mothership with smiles on their faces. All the objectives of the Romulus mission are completed. Now, astronauts will proceed with making some more science, and they are waiting for the return window that will open in over a year. That would be all for today. Thank you everyone for watching, please press like and subscribe if you enjoyed it, and see you again in my next video.